When you think that, part of the component of news coverage around the country every year is the excitement and the fun that people get watching an old building being demolished, and they wired very carefully for days, and it's a very careful operation in order to make sure that a building comes down safely. I think the last one we saw was when they brought down one of the old casinos in Las Vegas. I mean, this is just stunning to see these things come down.
That's gonna come here.
I told you that sucker was gonna go.
That's coming here, isn't it?
What, the cloud?
Yeah, look at that.
Oh yeah.
Salomon Brothers building. That's 47 stories tall. There you can see it going. So this happened, some 6 hours or so after the collapse of the World Trade Center.
About an hour after the actual explosion, which was about 9:15 in the morning. If you wanted to calculate a time to cause maximum disruption, you would calculate that time as the start of the working day in perhaps the biggest, busiest complex in the world. There were those two explosions. I was at the base of one of those.
Blair spoke of a battle between the democratic world and terrorism.
When I was directing traffic at...
And, you know, in terms of the fatalities, you know, Rudy Giuliani said, this is Building 7 again. We're going to just replay what you've just seen. This is Building 7 in the World Trade Center area is collapsing. Now, whether we don't even know whether this was something that was engineered for safety reasons or it just happened as a consequence of the two collisions this morning, where the two airliners hit the two towers.
Mm.
Understanding that building had been evacuated when the collapse occurred.
This was known as Building 7 of the World Trade Center, and that is fresh video you're looking at of that coming down.
Now, again, they were able to get everybody out of that building before it collapsed. So I don't know whether it was accomplished by demolition experts or whether it just happened as a consequence of what occurred earlier today.
That building number 7 was going to collapse. That appears to be what has happened now. I don't know exactly how many stories the building is, Dan, but standing at the base of it, watching it burn about an hour ago, it looked to be something on the order of 50, 60 stories, as you said, a very, very large office building.
And since in the most recent collapse, which happened just a short while ago, Building 7, a 47-story building.
No. Truth Action points to World Trade Center Building number 7 that was behind the Twin Towers and how it went down that day.
It looks like a typical controlled demolition. It came down to the ground in 6.6 seconds, which is basically free fall speed, which is basically means there's no resistance.
In fact, you were just told by police that you should move out of your apartment, Fabiana.
Yes.
You've got Carolina here?
Yes. They advised us to leave because we have...
Oh, my God. Look behind us. Please pan in this way. Please be careful of your baby. This is it.
That's the building coming down.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. No. No. We're... Listen. We'll be all right. We'll be all right.
We're okay. I think we're okay. Ashley, I think we're okay. You're going to...
But in New York late this afternoon, a third damaged building, the 40-story World Trade Center number 7, also crashes to the ground.
Earlier in a report from Dawn Fratangelo about a woman who was coming out of the building, she said the firemen were going up and then she just knows that they were lost.
Now, as you continue to describe what you have seen, we're looking at the tape now, Jeff.
Okay, good. This once again happened only within the last few minutes. We saw one of those smaller buildings just fall to the ground.
Amazing, incredible, pick your word. For the third time today, it's reminiscent of those pictures we've all seen too much on television before when a building was deliberately destroyed by well-placed dynamite to knock it down.